See what happens here in the last one. Arise Kimmel ban for Immortals, Varus ban for Team Envy. And again, not expecting too many surprises here in these first six bans.
Yeah, expect a LeBlanc, expect a Shen as well, and a Rengar. I expect Rengar from, yeah, Shen, and I expect Rengar.
Well, there's Shen, and is there Rengar? Yep, there it is, taken away from Darduk.
First,
so where
Graves.
Do we want to go? First pick Graves, that seems like the
oh, wait,
one.
No.
They love the Rumble.
That's right. It's exactly what they did in game one. Same band, same first pick here. It's how Immortals won, so I guess they're going to go with it again.
I think it's also, honestly, how Envy won in part as well. Jace Rumble is such a good duo because you have huge damage in two of your lanes. They tend to either win or split most of their lanes as well. They can be super proactive if your jungle is aggressive, which both of these junglers are. And we saw it with CLG's draft yesterday. You don't want to stack too many ADs because then they just build armor and beat you. So oh. Having diversity as far as your damage types go, Rumble and Jace kind of do that together, which is always great to see.
Oh boy. Okay. And
well,
so I think
dead. Let's go.
Yeah, they're actually, like you said, they're trying to actually diversify their damage palette so that they have magic damage top lane on Immortals. Now they can play the Talon or whatever they wanted mid. And Envy now have the opportunity to take that for
ooh,
themselves.
They do take Talon. Talon Elise is a pick for Team Envy.
I mean, this might be a little premature as well because Talon was played by Ninja previously, but now Pole Belter gets to play whatever he wants into it. And I think Zed was an okay answer.
Well, we got Malzahar as well to maybe lock it down. It's going to be support for Olay. Is Jhin also for Cody's son? But going away from the Ashe, wanting to deny that Jhin from Apollo, which, given the game 2 performance, can't really blame them for. And then a Renekton here for Seraph. Going to play this matchup again, maybe.
I definitely think Renekton's incredibly strong. Yeah, they did lock it in there. This does mean that you should probably ban Ziggs if you are Immortals, because they are probably looking for that in the bottom lane.
Well, there's Graves ban for Team Envy, so jungler's falling pretty far through the draft here. Team Envy picked one in their first phase, but Immortals
Rek,
did not.
Rek,
maybe. That's true.
Push them far enough down, maybe it happens.
Well, Immortals, do they start things off as we expect with that Ziggs ban? Do they go in a different lane that they want to target? There's the obvious one. Good call there, Zyrian. Ziggs bot banned away by Immortals.
Kha'Zix, I assume, would be the next ban here if Team Envy are pinching the jungle.
Slowly but surely. Push him towards the purple monster. See what Envy want to do here. Do they have a different target ban in mind? We have seen teams start to split up their phase 2 ban some of the time, but not this time. Envy target down one roll, and a second jungler in Kha'Zix is banned away.
Man, you know what? If he does pick Rek'Sai, it's the greatest birthday gift of all, because it makes me right.
That's true. I
mean, doesn't happen on any other day but my birthday.
It's also good with Rumble, so I mean, the, yeah, conditions look good.
Yeah, I mean, it's fair weather right now.
And there's that fan from Immortal, still wanting to take that AD carry off the table as well. Kind of expected. Jungle target for one side, bottom lane target on the other side for Immortals.
Yep, and they took away the Malzahar so that the Sivir or the Caitlyn are really what's up here, but you won't have the Caitlyn plus Malzahar combo available to you. Because Envy are last picking their support here.
That is Zyra again for Harker Hope. We'll have to see. Sivir is the first one here, so we're probably going to have a good team fighting AD carry, but pretty short range here. And again, lots of AD being stacked. I do like the Elise to kind of mix it up a bit for Envy, but not nearly as impactful as, say, a Rumble, unless Lyra gets incredibly far ahead, which is possible. But Immortals have to finish this team comp. We'll see what they want. Jace is open, so they'll take it. Pobolt are happy with that one. Should be just fine matchup-wise as well. And Olay...
You get to take Exhaust, too.
Yep. Super good against Assassins.
One of the beautiful things of running the Jace mid, used to be like one of the beautiful things of running Corki mid, is you get to have 2 Exhausts. So you really make the Assassins feel pretty worthless, and that they almost have never have a time to jump in. And nope, that's the next one on his tier list, most likely. The Lee Sin is clean, so at least I get that.
Certainly good. And there is Lee Sin, Jace, the last few picks for Immortals. We'll see what support Envy have in mind. Do they just go back to something like the more comfort pick for Hakuho in the Zyra? Had a good impact on it last game, but instead they want a defensive support. Malzahar, oh sorry, Lulu, kind of the other good support into Malzahar. Of course, MF is the one for Olay, but I like this a little bit more here for Envy. Adding a bit more team fight into their composition here.
Yeah, a little more durability as well that you can just throw onto somebody, because Immortals, again, kind of a tankless composition. The jungler will eventually go into tank with Lee Sin.
I mean, he's a fighter slash bruiser, really, so
yeah.
Darduk isn't going to offer that much resistance. Envy on the other side are using this Lulu pick to transform Renekton into just a fighter, into more of a full-on tank, at least temporarily. with the ultimate and with the shield. So Envy certainly looking to, you know, win early, which they love to do. They've got a good top half of the map to do that with. But then if they have to get to team fights, play 5v5, it's kind of what happened last game for them when they won.
Yeah, it's interesting because Envy have a snowballing composition with a Talon, a Renekton, and Elise. You can get early leads. You can just run over the top side of the map like you were saying, Pastry. And the bottom lane is kind of their insurance. They brought a wave clear AD carry when they already had Varus off the table, and Caitlyn would have been kind of the next thing down, but it's still not as much wave clear as the Sivir. So he's kind of the insurance there for if the Talon gets behind. You still have a way to clear the waves and to stop sieges.
And it's smart from Envy. I think it fits exactly how we want their team to play. Aggressive top half of the map that can snowball, more consistent teamfight side on the bottom half. Immortals on the other side, they're pretty much doing what they did in game one, just picking all damage.
Yeah, absolutely. But this is what we've seen this whole series, bashing each other's heads against each other. And so we're seeing a ton of carries and a ton of damage.
Well, it's been a lot of fun so far, so we'll have to see how it all works out. We are going to get ourselves into our final game of week six, Irene. You and I will get the honors of rounding out this one. We're getting closer and closer to playoffs. But IMT and Envy have one game to play left before week six is done and dusted. We had an awfully fun game one and a pretty fun game two. I'm expecting a bloodbath. Immortals seem to just want to hit the go button as many times as possible.
So we may see a bloodbath. I think we're probably going to see a lot of exhausted people. There's four exhausts in this game. It becomes really difficult to make plays, and so people might get a bit paralyzed by the fact that the exhaust could come out. Get that gold, Hakuo. You get that.
He has stolen so much gold from Cody, son. Ole trying to answer back. Ninja's here, though. Rakes out. Ninja not going to get snared up either by the W, Cody, son. Not the best level one skill for him to have, but isn't going to hurt him too much, and good bit of gold early for Hakuo. Envy do try and play aggressive. IMT forced to back, but we'll make it to lane with plenty of time.
We'll see if Pobelter ends up respecting Ninja's ability to combo, because the amount of damage that you're able to do with the Talon on both pass-throughs of the W, plus your Noxian Diplomacy, ends up being a gigantic burst. We're talking like 300-plus damage on just a level 2, and most characters have about 600 HP.
And we saw what happened to Ninja in game 1. See if Ninja can do that to Pobelter. A little trickier without the Ignite, but I do like the defensive choice here. Ninja gets a ward down early, and now Dardock going to get a bit of help from Flame and starting blue buff. So the first non-Raptor invade game in a while. Both junglers actually starting on their blues.
See what he ends up doing from there. Lee Sin invading the blue, or actually, sorry, taking his own blue is really strange. It usually means you're going to go do either that full side of the jungle, or you're gonna go for something interesting.
Oh, that's so much damage.
What is? Oh, yeah. Gets chunked out there. And that's the combination as well that you have to watch out for. The reason that this started popping up is people are like, oh, Malzahar is really good. Oh, Jhin's really good. And then together, they ended up making a really good combination because of the fact that he's the only AD carry that has pre-level 6 CC root, besides a Caitlyn trap, but this one is much easier to land. That allows the Voidlings to just nom away at somebody.
Really trading there for Ninja as well, but he's got three biscuits for that longsword start, so should be plenty healthy in these crates. Pobelter just with the Doran's Blade, already used his one consumable. We'll see if Ninja continues to hammer there. Also went Storm Raiders for Ninja, so playing definitely more for the skirmish in the team fights rather than just the direct lane impact.
Yeah, the Storm Raider Surge is the get in, chase them down, they can't get away, and then get out, because there's so many lethality items now. Like, one of the changes that happened around the time that Talon got reworked was there's so much out-of-combat movement speed on things like Ghost Blade and all the lethality items. But so he doesn't have to buy those mobility boots, but talking about
level 3 that, dive here. Flame gonna get snared up. There's the stun from Seraph as well. Absolutely massive play. Huge first blood for Lyra.
Man, the reason that we're seeing this Elise so much is that people are getting pushed down the tier list a bit, but I will say Graves was still on the table, Kha'Zix was still on the table, and Lyra's just like, no, this is a comfort champion for diving and getting these snowball lanes ahead. Both the Talon and the Renekton are easy pickings then that you can go to those lanes and kill their lane opponent.
Perfect looking dive there from Envy. Flame held on to his flash because he didn't have an opportunity to use it.
There's no flash in sight either for both of Envy's people involved in that dive. It's just super easy for them to pull off.
Really nice stuff. It's been a while since you've seen a good old-fashioned top lane tower dive at level 3.
Yeah. And it's really strange too. Dardock's route was do blue buff, back, didn't smite or anything like that to get HP back, then went to the bottom side of the jungle, full cleared bottom side jungle. Lyra kills top, and now he's going back to his top side jungle, but it's completely warded out, and he'll get spotted when he starts doing his Gromp here, which will now actually key Lyra to do whatever he wants. He's probably clear the remainder of his jungle and get the Raptors and then move.
Yep, double Cloth Armor now for Flame, so aware of the damage potential of Renekton early. There's double Doran's on the other side for Seraph, so trying to make that all count. Bottom lane though, much more even as far as early CS goes, so a little bit of trouble for Envy. Taking too much damage from Jhin Malzahar, but should be a pretty straightforward lane for Apollo and Harko. Only really just need to get things pushing. Cody-san and Ole, not the same super strong duo lane they had with the Ash MF, really able to bully out early. A little more finesse required to get some damage done. You don't just kind of spam your AoE out.
Hello!
Tardok spotted! Does get himself over the wall. Lyra's gonna chase. He's got the red buff. Huge gonna miss from Bo Belter. Just so much damage. Ninja over the wall though. First, he's gonna get himself thundering blade back over. Bo Belter gonna go down though. Great combo by Envy.
You can't keep him out. He's just gonna hop over. He's gonna flash over. He's gonna keep getting in there. Oh, the exhaust. I was talking about it. They keep coming through. They just throw off your damage in your head. You're just like, I can do this much. Nope, you know you can't.
Well, they all get expended, so mid laners with no summoner spells, but Envy find themselves two kills up to nothing. 1,500 gold ahead at 5.5 minutes is real good.
Now, Dardock going to look towards the bottom side of the map here.
Something needs to work. Exhausted down onto Apollo. Oh. That snare did not connect. And now another dive for Flame here. He's going to go down. Lyra tanking for his
long as he can.
Needs to repel. Doesn't have it. It's a trade there for IMT.
I wonder where the repel was there. Possibly on cooldown, maybe close the gap or something along those lines, because that just looked like... Oh, kill that didn't have to go over, but they blew a flash on Lyra, blew a flash on Flame. Lyra's was from before when he went over the wall at the Raptor camp. But then immediately, like, he almost died, and he's like, nah, I'm going top. Boom. Still actually just being present on the map, caring more about his laners than his own jungler CS or any of those.
Yep, he's got mobility boots. He's keeping up decently in CS, but he's on a mission. Looks like Envy are just going to maybe even try Snowball Seraph as fast and as soon as possible. He is... 20 CS ahead already, as we'll watch this one again from Lyra.
Yeah. Flash the cocoon. And yeah, plenty of time.
He must have not had it then.
Unsure. But down bottom lane, Apollo, the root didn't land because he actually hit his spell shield in that time. So, not able to get caught out there.
Smart stuff from Apollo, and actually dodged the gank. Kind of chunk out Cody's son. Immortals don't get nothing there. And it really, it's Envy that's dictated every single play in this game so far. 3-1, still up in kills and up in goal, but that one was just a trade from maybe a misplay from Envy.
Yeah, Lyra's actually a surprisingly good jungler. Darlok talked about it before game one in that little play that we had, a little sound on tape. And he was talking about how Lyra, you know, you shouldn't underestimate this guy. He's actually a good jungler. He's actually quite good. So right now, looking for another dive, the Elise, he's just trying to take over the game. There is no hesitancy here, they are going.
Oh, Ninja straight in, good silence there from the Malzahar. Cody-san gets one, but it's gonna cost him his life. Ninja is gonna go down as well.
What?
Steal! Shoot! Oh. Silence is enough, Ole snipes him.
Oh, that ends up being 2-for-1. There is no hesitance there at all. Lyra, again, no repel. Gets targeted by the turret, doesn't drop the aggro. If he dropped the aggro, it still would have gone to Ninja. That was just way too aggressive.
Yeah, and Envy might be playing a little too far forward. I did check. Lyra just didn't hit repel in that gank. Had it.
In the top one?
In the top lane, yeah.
Oh, God.
Just didn't use it.
What? That's like, that. Okay.
I don't know what to tell you.
Man, he's a mixed bag. I'm like, man, he's playing so well right here. He's got to have it, right? Oh, his silence for just.
Yeah, oh, they played that
just,
so well.
Just barely. Just barely. That silence duration had just almost come off.
We got more action. No time to analyze. Hakuho. Exhaust maybe gonna stop it all. Blood block there from Apollo. Silence again.
Yeah.
Things can't chase though.
I don't know if they were expecting that because he's actually maxing silence first. He's got 3 points in Q. Sometimes you put it into the W for the extra damage, but it's that silence duration that actually goes up every rank. And so it was just enough to get him a kill on Lyra.
Really nice stuff there. Ole, a little unconventional, but making it work here. Defending well. 7 kills already in 8.5 minutes. We're on track for the bloodthirsty game I was kind of expecting, but a blue buff still here from Lyra. It's going to be nice stuff there for Envy.
Yeah, it's interesting as well because when we're talking about Ole, it's like you can probably leave Malzahar up against him because he's not going to pick it, right? We talked about this series. He'll pick something like the Misfortune if it's up. He'll pick the Morgana, right? But turns out that Ole, not a bad Malzahar right there. Landing those cubes.
I think in general, Immortals are finding kind of a combination of the meta stuff and then their personal style and getting it. Altogether, Flame's Rumble is a good example of this for me, where it's a strong meta champion and enables Flame to do what he wants to do, which is try and carry.
It was talked about at the start of the day today, where the meta seems to be play what you're good at, but still respect the meta. Because comfort and the difference between the comfort is worth so much, and the difference between the champions in tier list is like, oh, this is S tier. It's like probably just LeBlanc. The rest you can just piece it together and it'll work out.
Yeah, LeBlanc, Varus, but that's kind of it.
Yeah.
As far as the super strong champions goes, Ninja getting harassed down by Pobalta, gonna grab his blue buff, but impact hasn't really been felt just yet for Ninja. Had the one roam down bottom lane, but got himself killed. Only able to really leave lane once. Pobalta's doing a good job keeping the lane shoved in and anchoring Ninja to his turret for as long as possible.
Yeah. I mean, it's hard for Ninja to really get too much done here up against Pobalta because the Jace, just the running the exhaust will stop him from all inning. And then the Jace also does a gigantic chunk of damage. And if you walk up to try and CS at all, well, he just actually punishes you.
Let's see if Pobalta having this wave kind of push back a bit. Good rake there from Ninja. The creep, but Pobalta slaps these down. And again, able to leave the lane very quickly if he needs to. Dardok still back in his bottom lane. Fed an awful lot of attention here from Immortals.
They're just going for a clear. Just sweeping out the area, making sure that they get rid of all the control wards in there. One was in there and actually just got replaced. So he's going to take this, and it's Mountain Drake that's on the table.
Might want to take it. He's going to maybe make a play in bottom lane first. Dardok lining up for a tower dive now, but yep. Control ward's going to spot him. He'll take that down.
Wasn't there before. That's the one that got replaced.
Now the Envy knows the threat is there. Dardok, though, just going to get some deeper vision down. Doesn't need to rush this play.
Yeah, watch how back these guys play. They're like, nope, nothing happening here. No possible gank, because they have nothing. It's like it's actually completely dark bottom side of the jungle for Envy. And they can't see anything. And Lyra's going to make a play on the top half. And look at that. Flame's like, nope, I'm out of here. And it's the correct play.
Spots it this time. He's still behind 20 CS. Seraph is doing a nice job with that early assistance from Lyra bullying this lane. But, I mean, bottom lane's up for IMT. Dardok's been applying a lot of pressure there as well. Mid lane's the even one as far as that CS goes. And again, Pobalta is just happy to play back and farm because he knows that if Ninja doesn't leave his lane, he's not going to do too much.
Yeah, it's definitely where both junglers are playing to. For the top side for Envy getting the dive, and the bottom side for Immortals where they picked up a few kills early on.
Hakuho again taking that damage. So much silence DPS under Hakuho. Ole nailing those skill shots time and time again. And again, just chilling out. Has everything available. Maybe look for an all-in here. I think Immortals going to try and press for a play. Dardok on the wrong side of the map for that, though. Seraph roaming down, seeing what he can spot. Actually got a very deep, very deep wards into their jungle.
And it looks like a roam from Ninja.
It's just a bait. Feints going down bottom lane. Instant call from IMT, so Cody-san and Ole back off. No need to overcommit there.
Nope. Pobalta interrupts his back to continue to deal with Ninja. It's not a cannon minion wave, so Ninja will clear this out. Actually has superiority in mana. So Pobalta, yeah, he's actually just kind of suffering here.
You know, again, we had those 7 quick kills in this game, but IMC playing a little slower now. Envy starting to find some more pockets to make plays in. Ninja with the blue buff especially was really shoving down the lane. I think maybe there's some gold discrepancy. No, they actually both have a lot of gold to spend, so it's not bad.
Dardok down bottom.
Oh, Ole flash. Ultimate snared up as well. Hakuho not going to get to ulti. He does barely. Kick's going to get him out to safety. Has to flash, but he gets out.
Oh, man. Is the kick for the execute there? But he's locked up, I believe, during that time by Ole. If he's not doing enough damage in that time and not even getting behind a rooted target, then that's an issue.
Ruining his reputation about that cleanly sin.
I mean, he might die there.
Oh.
He's bled.
Oh! Talon is sniping him down. That was an insane amount of damage, actually.
It actually does so much. That's one of the things that I think is giving people an edge with Talon, is they don't know how much damage it's going to do when he gets the 3 and then it bleeds. It's a significant amount of damage when he has the 3 wounds and the auto attack behind it.
And Dardok, oy, it's just looking a little rough for him. Although Pobalta might be able to trade one back. Exhaust saturated. Ninja, good flash.
And then he gets out.
Able to zip away. There's plenty of walls to get to. And now Envy converged with 3 and strong onto this outer turret. Going to try and take the bonus goal for themselves. Ole and Cody-san trying to AoE it down. Pobalta going to come down, but he might be a little late. Envy teleporting down. But here's the teleport from IMT. Cancelled for both. And everyone walks away.
Yep. Still pushed them off the turret. Got the Sivir ultimate as well. Seraph looking top up against Flame. Not teleporting in. Not roaming either, but he has definitely an advantage here. And This is right after the play where Darlok no longer has to kick.
He's also two levels behind.
Q's in. Ninja. That was a smooth combo. That was actually super smooth from Ninja. Because he actually gets an auto attack woven in there too that you don't really see.
Well, Darlok pays for it with his life, although he's back onto the mountain Drake. Ninja looking for something topside though. Seraph is very strong in his 1v1. So Immortals are going to get an objective off of it, but can Envy take down Seraph or maybe even just the turret? Looks like they might be on the blue buff right now as the mountain Drake goes over to Immortals. Blue buff going to be stolen away by Ninja, and Flame is completely zoned off this turret. Seraph actually going to proxy this wave.
Proxy, yeah. He's playing as if it's already gone. First turret has not gone down yet. It's an early lead for Envy. We talked about in Champion Select, the top half of the map, the Renekton, the Elise, and then also having the Talon. This is like Snowball City. You want to play towards your top half of the map. You want to get them rolling. And that's what Envy have been able to accomplish so far. You look at even where the kills and assists are right now. Bottom lane hasn't had much to say, but Envy, even top lane turret here goes down. This is the snowball that they're looking for.
Pure gold going to Seraph as well. He is approaching 1,500 gold ahead of his main opponent.
Yeah, he's getting up there right now.
The Immortals do try and trade back on this turret. Blue buff was given over to Pobelta, so it's just a trade. No steal forthcoming for Envy.
Yeah, their top half of the map is actually just incredibly far ahead. 1,800 gold ahead for Seraph. In the jungle, it's 1,400. And then in the mid lane, it's about 800 there. So all three of those members of Envy pretty much are the gold lead right now.
Yep.
Whereas the 80 carries, pretty even, and same as supports.
And that's kind of, again, all Envy really want to do. Ninja backing on the Pobelta, though.
That's a collapse.
Does leap down. Damage isn't there, but Seraph actually diving in. Lyra here as well. Cocoon's going to land in, and Ninja gets himself the kill.
This is getting really scary for Immortals. And Envy, if they win this, that'll put him at 3-9. And put him back down.
Flash forced on the Cody Sun. Blobcone is there, gets him out, but Lyra going to get ultied up.
They left him.
Ninja now has to get out to safety. Hops over the wall. Lyra getting chased down, but Seraph able to block the last few shots.
Oh my god.
It's okay. He repelled. He didn't die. Lyra didn't dodge last one, but didn't do enough damage either.
That's interesting, because the Blast Cone got taken at the same time as Ole's like, time to ulti. Maybe could have killed a person or two there, but everybody got out of dodge.
Desynchronized just a bit. Envy will hold onto their lead. I feel like the top half of the map starting to come alive here for Envy. Just such a good dive on a Pobelta.
Yeah, I like this. Ninja pops the ulti that also pushes the minion wave up because it kills that last one that's up there. So they start taking some turret shots, then the flank in, and then here, a little bit caught out. Cody Sun over the wall. Has to get away from Hakuo and Apollo. Then they go over, and it's like, wait, guys, I swear. Maybe could have, but it was still very risky to do so.
Yeah, ultimate not going to pick anyone up either for Jin, so play dissipates, and it's just the kill on Pobelta that they get. No extra turrets taken for Envy, but now Ninja is topside. Looking to maybe get some damage done onto Flame. This is pretty tricky for Flame to deal with. Already having trouble with Renekton. It's not going to fare much better with Talon.
Yeah, not much better at all, especially with all those armor penetration items, the lethality. And this is what you do with the Talon. If you're trying to play it in solo queue, even if you're top, I mean, he was one of the highest win rate top laners. Hold on.
Caught here by Lyra, equalizes it down for Flame, but Pobo's going to get jumped up by Ninja.
Hakuo.
Too many people for Envy to kill. Hakuo takes out Darlok on the other side. Lyra looking to line up yet another cocoon. Just get some auto attacks down. Envy instead going to start sieging.
Yep. And if you're playing this Talon, you just jump over the walls, you take control of a side lane. Don't stay in that mid lane because that's just where you get to other lanes roaming. And then when you play to a side lane, you cause pressure and then you can take over the jungle. And if there's any fights or skirmishes in the jungle, you have ways in and out.
Looks like we might have found Envy's early game trying to take this turret down. Terra for the 1v2 situation as the TP's coming in. Now 1v3 has to run out from under the ultimate. First bullet's going to tag him. Next one's going to miss. And Seraph is hogging all the walls, able to dodge out the rest.
Flame canceling the TP to help out. And it looks like Hakuo and Apollo on this mid lane turret, and they're going to get that second outer turret here. Whereas Envy had already claimed the tier 2 top.
Yeah, that's three turrets now to nothing there on the Immortal side. And Envy's early game is snowballing out of control. They have 6,000 gold ahead at 18 and a half minutes.
And we've seen a lead similar to this from a composition similar to this as well. And it needs a little bit more before you're comfortable. But when you hit that point, about 8,000-ish, you're definitely taking over the game. You're able to get those Barons quite quickly. And also, the fact that Immortals got that Mountain Drake first is kind of a godsend to them, because it definitely would help Envy so much And it also helps Immortals a lot with Jace. If Jace ever gets to a point where Pobelter is able to get to these turrets, or if they're able to look at a Baron, then it's so much more damage, and you're able to actually shred it and get away back into the game.
Well, Envy going to go back, spend their gold, and reset the map once more. I've certainly given a lot of credit to Immortals this weekend for how well they've played cleanly once they've got a lead of this nature. Envy, certainly a team that looks pretty lost in some of the mid-to-late situations, but if they can execute well here, it's a big boon for the team, and of course it'll give them the win in the series.
Yeah. Envy, of course, they went 3 games against FlyQuest, so I want to talk about these two teams in their games or matches this week, because they went 3 games against FlyQuest. They played Mordekaiser, were thrown for a little bit of a loop against Envy. Envy dropped that series, but it still went to 3 games against one of the top teams. Now, they're game 3 right now up against Immortals, who were 5-6 in the standings. And if Immortals lose to Envy, Immortals will have lost to Liquid and Envy, who were the 2-8 record teams, the tied for last place teams in the NALCS, and that does not bode well for Immortals at all. That actually is a big red flag.
Now, if you're Immortals here, sitting at the spot you are kind of in playoff contention just barely, you're looking at this week saying these are the easiest points we're going to get for the rest of the season. So O2 is a disaster in so many ways, and for Envy, it might be the momentum they need to push themselves up. They might not make playoffs, but there's still a chance, and you know, the only way to do that is just keep winning.
Yeah, but if you're Immortals, you're actually, like you said, in playoff contention, but there are teams catching up to you. Echo Fox now have a 5-7 record themselves, whereas Immortals are at 5-6. They lose this, they're tied with Echo Fox, and then Phoenix won another game, and then we're seeing all these teams kind of jockey for position up a little higher. So Immortals risk dropping down.
Flash ult there from Ole. Ninja gonna get snared up by the Jin W. Dotta kicks him right this time, and Cody Sun collects a freebie.
Well, they're gonna trade it for this Drake. That was, he was kind of trying to provide pressure on the side lane. It's not wrong to do his Talon, but if you get caught like that and you're not up against the wall and have your escape routes, that's the easiest place to kill the Talon. He can't jump off the map. He can't use that one.
Did get the turret out of the deal before, but overstayed a little too long trying to get the wave pushing back in their favor. Envy, though, still holding firm as a 6K lead. Apollo, much easier for him to just take down these waves and get them pushing in the right direction.
Yeah, and I definitely think Ninja made the right decision there. Like you said, was going after the turret. Now has a QSS, so that won't happen again to him in terms of just getting locked up and destroyed. And that's really only the CC on Immortals that is good for hard engaging. Cody Sun can ulti and maybe get a W afterwards, but that's like, that's stretching there. That's like throwing down an Equalizer and a Nami Wave type hard engage. Those are just multiple soft engages. So Dardock had to go for a kickback as well, I guess.
Seraph is still firmly ahead in this top lane. But the team, I got the Black Cleaver. Now I expect his Kalsa starting to maybe itemize a little more defensively. But as far as 1v1 versus the Rumble goes, Flame has not a whole lot to say about that 1v1. Will be impactful in team fights if he can position the Equalizer well. He's got a Zhonya's. And of course, that Haunting guy is building into the Liandry's. So he's approaching kind of some relevant points for him. But maybe should have a 3-lane pressure if they want it. Or maybe if they group Seraph like this together, they can get some sort of 4-1 going, because I can tell you Ninja ain't leaving the side lanes.
He's not leaving these side lanes until something happens that really requires him there. I'm looking at the items though. Ninja Tabi across the board for Immortals. I feel like everybody's realizing just how much they negate with their, I believe it's 30 armor, and then the fact that they reduce 12% of the damage from basic attacks. It's quite substantial, and that means it's constantly scaling up with people critting you and dealing extra damage on those basic attacks. Even AD carry has it with Cody Sun, and it's just apparently so good that Flame, even though he can play from a distance, is still taking them over his Sork shoes.
Yep, and Envy do need to press their lead, kind of for that reason. Talked about the teamfight insurance with the Sivir and the Lulu, but IMT, despite having no pure tank, although Dardock is itemizing pretty defensively, given that he hasn't had a superstar start to the game.
Yeah, it definitely becomes quite easy to shred through people like the Lee Sin. It's strange. It's so strange because like you'll play Lee Sin and you'll buy exactly the same items as like, let's say you're playing Maokai and you even went the same build. Not like Sunfire Cape or anything. You just went the same build. It's actually going to feel like you're way less tanky because you are.
Yeah.
Stat-wise and abilities to heal yourself.
Absolutely. Up and Envy make a gutsy Baron call here. You're going to have to maybe try and finish a Ninja Hop server. Looking to run interference. Baron. He's going to go over to Envy. Dardock not in time to steal it. Ninja going to just 1v1 him instead. Mira flashes over, but he doesn't land it. Envy trying to disengage successfully. Ninja tagged by the Q, but Dardock, he's booking straight out of there.
Almost went down there, but Ninja did the right thing. He jumped over the wall and played interference and made sure that they weren't able to pick it up. Now has the ability to clear out this minion wave.
very quickly, actually.
Oh, he's gonna get out.
Seraph wants Dardock, went a little too deep. Actually, he's using everything to get over and try and chase the kill down. Ninja, he's the one that can really chase him down. There's one wall, looking to maybe go up another. Pops a ghost play, finds Flame, equalize it down.
Ninja gonna go over that wall too?
Flame got snared. Ninja, he there does dare. Zhonya's now popped. Lulu ultimate doesn't get the knock up, but Flame is gonna get caught out of position. MB chase him all the way down.
Yeah, and this red buff's about to come up too. Maybe they'll take that on their way out. There they will. And then they're gonna look at that bottom wave. Ninja back to split pushing.
Yeah, big wave. Actually, Envy might just join together here. Seraph's gonna go back, spend some of his money. But Baron up here should leave Envy a lot of options to push down. And top wave as well also has to be dealt with by Cody's son. Envy starting to build a huge lead. Like one more turret and they're 10,000 gold ahead.
Yeah, I like the call. Exactly what they need to get this composition even further ahead, snowballing. And now you look at Immortals, it's not really a wave clear comp at all. Sucks to deal with these melee minions that are buffed up by the Baron buff. And so they're just gonna take all these outer turrets. There's no more outers or inners right now for Immortals. It's just those turrets that are guarding the Nexus and those inhibitors.
Love the guts there from Envy just to make the big call. And Envy, they've certainly got a lot of heart. If we can take nothing else away from this series, pretty much like all their success in this series has looked like just very strong Baron calls, committing to it as a team, doing it together, and looking really clean while doing so. It's not like, it's not random situations they're finding him in, but they're taking the riskier path has been paying off for them here, because in game one, they were just floundering.
Yeah, and I think the interesting thing here for Envy is when they play snowballing lanes, and there's a good early game for Lyra when he's playing something like the Elise that can dive and it's super easy, even if it's not exactly like quote-unquote meta like Graves, Rengar, Tyr, etc. It's working out because he gets the Renekton ahead, he'll help get the Talon ahead, help get some pressure there, and then he just takes over the jungle. Dardock two levels down, pretty irrelevant this game in terms of pressure, and Lyra's just been complete opposite. Highest kill participation on his team, he's been doing work, and this guy, Seraph, highly praised him and said that this is the best jungler he's ever played with. And some people were like, oh, you know, what are you talking about? Lyra's actually been the silent performer. The record of Envy does not actually accurately reflect Lyra's performance.
No, and they've just been on the rise in some ways. Early games have looked good, starting to convert that a little better. We'll see how they close out this game, because the Immortals are backs hard against the wall right now.
Yeah, if Lyra gets those repels down and doesn't give up early kills, then he's good to go.
I had to bring it up.
Nah, I do. I mean, we never criticize people, so.
That's true.
I'm just kidding. That's not true at all.
I mean, Immortals, I hate to keep repeating it, but when they are behind, it looks rough for this team.
It does.
Not even just like they don't know what to do, because I'm sure they know what to do. Just something in the mentally for this team. It just feels like they.
Well, it feels like Flame just keeps split pushing, Dardock keeps going for the same play over and over again. It's kind of like the definition of insanity.
Yeah.
Where if I keep split pushing and I keep trying to make this play, eventually it'll work out. It actually just makes him fall further behind.
Yeah, and the thing is, you know, when you're ahead, there's a great thing for this team to do.
Yeah.
Flame's really good in the 1v1. Dardock is a big playmaker for this team.
Yeah.
But when your tendencies don't change based on the situation, you're gonna look a little like this as Lyra does ridiculous damage to Flame just there.
Exactly. I was talking about it before where Flame's default is to go to a side lane, push, get farm, regardless of if he's ahead or behind. When he's ahead, it looks way better.
Oh, good.
Ah, Olay's gonna try to ulti him as soon as he comes down.
Oh, yep, there is the ulti. Ninja, though, gonna try and assassinate him instead. Spell shield's off, but Ninja has to keep running away. Flame forced to burn the Zhonya. Just good shots from Cody's son. Does deal damage to Ninja. Not enough to take him down, though. And Envy still broke the bottom side of the map, so Inhibitor open for them to take. They're gonna fall back and get the Cloud Drake here.
Yep, Inhibitor also open mid, so they have the mid and the bottom side of the maps completely open for Envy to go towards. And Cloud Drake, quite good for Talon. Talon has so much out of combat movement speed from, in fact, he'll get 20 from the Yomus, 20 from the Edge of Night, and then he'll also have the two Drakes, which give him 50 more. So we're looking at about 90 out of combat extra movement speed for the Talon. Moby Boots, who needs them?
Not this town,
nope,
for sure.
Not at all. Lyra, good equalizer. I like the diagonal equalizers that go big to small, because then they have to walk either over it completely. And most people's tendency is actually to let the equalizer herd them into a point, into a wall. And it's great. It actually covers a lot of distance and covers options.
Well, Envy, looking like they want to take everything here. Ninja's actually moving to the top lane. He's the best 1v1er right now, so it makes sense to move him into a side lane where you expect the most resistance. But Envy again just going to guide these minions down. They don't have Baron buff anymore, but it's back up in a minute 40 if they want to try and take it. They are so far ahead that they should be able to walk in and just brute force a fight. That given the advantage they have in gold, they should be able to win it cleanly. Immortals have to find a few miracles in a row and play some real good defense. They're going to keep this game afloat for themselves.
The defense has never been a more of a strength.
No, it hasn't. Lyra, though, face check is going to maybe give them something back here. Ooh, Voidling making it a little tricky. Ooh. As Ninja diving in. Goodbye, Ole. And now the Wild Grip from Lulu's going to let him just keep going. Dardock's the next target. Roberto a little late to this one. Ninja just keeps hopping over. He wants to kill everybody, but he gets exhausted, flashes himself out of the way to safety. Equalizer committed. Hakuho gets low, but he does not fall.
Yeah, it's just Ole that goes down there. Baron up in a minute, and now it's time to reset the map. Start getting little things that you can. But they have complete vision control here, too, for Envy's side.
Lyra staying out on the map by the looks of things. Takes the Honey Fruit. They will need to get some recalls in. Hakuho going to go back, get his health, replenish those ward charges, maybe pick up a control ward or three, and set up for this next objective. Immortals should know where they were going, but what can they do about it? It is so tough when you're this far behind to do anything other than make a miraculous-looking play. Dardock, if you've got a Baron Steel in you, now is the time to use it. Everyone again, just going back, making sure they do the standards. Apollo, three damage items already. Maybe has the Infinity Edge done as well.
Yeah, I was looking at damage items, and I was looking at Ninja picking up the Lord Dominic's Regards. It'll shred the 45% bonus armor penetration. And so I was like, okay, how much armor is there really? There's actually a substantial amount of armor with everybody buying Ninja Tabi. If you just look at Ninja Tabi and say that 45% is basically 50, it's so close. Just for the sake of math, you're actually getting about 15 armor penetration off of everybody who has Ninja Tabi. That's their only item, so it's actually a really good purchase here for the talent.
Well, there's the play from Envy. Seraph TP's deep into enemy territory, trying to cut off somebody, but Baron is up. It's going to run straight towards it and bait them in. Not going to start it just yet. IMT are acutely aware of what Envy's plan is here. If Envy do a lot of damage, it's Baron. They're going to start it up.
Getting shredded. About half HP now.
It's dead.
Yeah, they'll get a Shock Blast in there, but...
Nope. Barely. Ooh. Barely not.
Oh.
He closes down. Seraph locked up on the front line. Ninja
Flame in the back!
Assassination. Flame just dives straight in, looking for Hakuho and Apollo, but Apollo flashes over the wall to live. Lyra now diving back in on a Poebuster. Seraph is doing so much damage. Flame goes down to Hakuho. Seraph gonna look for Poebuster. He gets kicked over the wall by Dardock as they're still trying to chase him, but he takes down one. Crocodile's gonna slay two more.
Oh, he gets hit over the wall by Dardock. Dardock wants an escape. Dardock even has Flash there, but he still gets killed, and then it gets Poebuster killed on top of it.
Don't have enough damage. Envy just too far ahead. Gonna guide the Baron up minions into the only vulnerable spot left. Might end the game, might just take three in here. Whatever they decide, Immortals are going to be one and a half feet in the grave at this point.
Yeah, almost there. Almost there.
Almost there for Envy.
Envy looking for their third match win against Immortals here.
Gonna look for it. Immortals this week would have looked so promising for them. Seraph goes down though. A little too aggressive from Envy.
Cody maybe gonna save it?
Oh, Lyra goes down as well. Cody's son doing the DPS. Oh, now
TP
the TP in from Immortals.
There it is. IMT's gonna try to turn this around.
He doesn't have an equalizer, but he's awfully speedy. Hakuho trying to slow him down, but misses. Apollo burns the ultimate and just turns tail. Flame gonna get a turn around and gets Whimsy down. Wild Growth used and he's gonna die. Hakuho gets a third kill.
Oh, this bottom lane is so consistent from Envy. You can play to the top side, and it just does so much to get all these kills, these turret dives, etc. But you have a deathless bottom lane here. Incredibly consistent. Hakuho plays this really well, too. Watch Flame jump into the back. Hakuho is like, okay, I whimsy him when he turns around. Then they just burst him out, and Apollo gets over the wall as well. That's where he blows his flash to heal to stay alive. Ninja pushed Cody's son out of the fight. And Cody is the damage on Immortals right now. He's 5-1-2. He's actually doing really well for himself. The issue though is everybody else is struggling. 1-5-1 for Flame, 1-3-2 for Dardock, 0-3-1 for Poebuster. It really is Cody Sun is trying to put the team on his back, which is not something that people were expecting.
No, and we'll see if it's enough here for Immortals because they are still far behind with a minute left on the Baron buff. Super Minions pushing top lane, a Mountain Drake up for Envy in 25 seconds, and two very vulnerable inhibitors.
Exactly. And I feel like every time a teamfight starts, Ninja is just going to lock onto Cody-san and go straight after him. He has the QSS to deal with Olay trying to lock him up, and then the Malzahar will really contribute the exhaust, and then you can just use your ultimate if you're Ninja, wait out the exhaust and re-engage.
I mean, a lot of the reason Cody-san is doing so much damage is because he doesn't have a defensive item.
Yeah.
So it's a pretty
easy target. He's got Ninja
Tab. Okay, that's true. It's an easy target, though, for the Talon. Is Envy looking to shove this down? 40 seconds left on the Baron buff. Seraph doesn't have it, though. Who does have it left on Envy, actually?
Yeah.
Lost a couple of members there. There we go. Looks like Apollo. And, of course, the Deathless bottom lane still has it. So they're going to stick together and try and take this one down. Seraph moving over, making sure they have full five-man pressure.
Very consistent bottom lane. For Envy, Apollo's gonna throw out the damage.
Sivir also gonna help disengage. Good heal there. Able to block out the shot. Seraph tanks the last one. He's got a big pool of health to work with. Its inhibitor's gonna fall. Baron buff not up for too much longer, but Envy might just have enough time to take all the inhibs.
Mountain Drake's up as well. And this inhib looks like it's probably gonna go down right here. That's three inhibs down.
Just enough Baron buff left. Pobelta may be caught. Seraph gonna wait the ultimate from Olay, but Lyra leaping forward to try and take somebody down. Three inhibs down now. Lyra falls back down, but he's safe.
You gotta watch out for these Sivir crits. Boom, 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 boom. Look at those big 300s popping up across the team. They're just gonna start slowly pushing all of these minions in, and they're gonna try to end the game right here.
The cascade of pressure. Dada caught up by a cocoon. That's Hakuo and a rampage from the support role. Ninja dives in, looks for the assassination, and doesn't get it, but the Nexus open and exposed, and Envy are gonna take it down and take down Immortals!
Envy move to 3-9. They finally find their third match win. They found something that works out a little bit for them. Lyra, aggressive. It's been a struggle to convert his aggressive plays into mid-game safety for himself, but also the rest of the team. Camp early for these gigantic solo laners who can snowball in 1-3-1, and that seemed to be the winning formula. 1-3-1 for them with a ninja that can't be contested.
And again, just needed a little bit more aggression in some of their calls, a little bit more decisiveness. And two games in a row, they pull off some massive Baron attempts and a snowball from there. We said it at the, you mentioned it, we said it at the top of the day, play what you're good at. And this kind of comp makes perfect sense for Envy. They get exactly what they need to help them win the game and how they want to play, and it just looks easy.
Yep, it looked really easy for them. Immortals, though, on the other hand, it was a struggle. Their top half of the map did not function really well at all, firing on different cylinders. And Cody-san and Olay have looked better. That game, 5-1-2 for Cody-san, Olay 1-1-6. They're not really the issues in these games. They got some attention from Dardock, but then the top half of the map was sacrificed, ended up being what Envy needed to win, and what Immortals didn't really see coming, apparently.
Coming into this series, you expect the opposite, honestly, for Immortals. You think they've got three strong players, Pobelta, Flame, great carries, Dardock, excellent jungler, and you think, you know, if that's how they're going to win, they should have an advantage on paper versus Envy. Bottom lane's been looking better, which is good, because that's the traditional weakness for Immortals this season, but just none of that seemed to matter. Envy just had the answers today.
Yeah, and this was also consistent for Immortals throughout the last few days, because the two matches they played, Liquid and Envy, they lost to both teams that were tied for last place, which is really bad looking at the standings, because they could catch them eventually, and then there may be a tiebreaker that has to get played for bottom slots. So Immortals, those are not wins that you should be dropping. Everybody else around you is picking them up, and you're not, so you're falling down the standings, and you're in danger of falling out of playoff position, as we only have six more matches to play.
Yeah, and Immortals, I mean, when they look good, they look great. When they look bad, it looks worse. Like, the inconsistency of this team, it felt like they were getting it together.
Yeah.
Like, bottom line starting to play better. It should all be coming together, but they can't run together. Something always has to fall off the cards.
Yeah, right. That's where I was going to go to, because Cody-san and Olay, they're like, we're doing it. We're back on track. Pobelter's like, I dropped the ball against Piglet, guys. I dropped the ball against Ninja. And Dardock, you know, he's jumping in a whole bunch as well. And then Flame is off doing his own thing. And then there's games where it's like, Dardock's going off. And then, oh, bottom lane, what's going on, man? They can't seem to take care of the whole map simultaneously, whereas I will say that there, you do have to take small losses places when you're making plays on other parts of the map, but not to this degree, not to where you're actually just losing lanes super hard, losing multiple lanes, because the top teams, you watch them, and they will actually minimize their losses and maximize what they get off of their plays.
Yeah, well, NBA looking good and much more cohesive than we used to see. But that's it from us here at the desk. So let's check in with our analysts to break down that series and close out the weekend.
Thank you very much.